What is it like to be a dentist? My name is Dr. Paul Goodman. A lot of people know me as Dr. Nacho, and I've been a dentist for 18 years here in Pennington, New Jersey, practice owner for 15 years here in Pennington, New Jersey. So you may be on this dental group thinking like, I might be a dentist in a few years. I'm a dental student. I'm a new dentist. I work in the dental industry. So what does it feel like to be a dentist? Let me share with you. Number one, it feels like you're doing full contact arts and crafts on people who don't want to be here and most definitely don't want to pay for it. What's another way that I could describe being a dentist? Oh, here's a good one. Being the star of a Broadway play that nobody wants to see. Literally the opposite of Hamilton. But this is the life we've chosen, dentisting humans. And I'm here for my dentisting day, and I want to share with you a few tips because it is hard to be a dentist. It is difficult to process so many people all day long. You need systems. Everything that matters needs a system, and everything matters. But let me share some insight into the first hour of my day from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. So I saw four human beings, wrote them out here for you. These four human beings I saw from 9 to 10, like a little pinball going around. Anyone play pinball? Is that even a thing anymore? I'm not sure. But what is it like? What I did, first visit, post-op, for an implant, the periodontist placed. So you think that's easy? Not so easy. You want to know why? Because the patient also, next step, tooth will benefit from a new crown. So we discussed the new crown on number 19. You know what the patient said? Why does my insurance stink? Here's my talking tip, which I put over here. Dental insurance is like a coupon with blackout dates. We're going to do the best job possible to maximize the benefits of your coupon. So maybe I don't need to look in the mouth for 30 seconds, but I have to spend 7-8 minutes with that patient with other patients in the other chairs. Then we had a patient who had an extraction bone graft, tooth removal and bone preservation on teeth number 5 and 14. And today was the healing check and to take implant guide impressions using my favorite material, Silgenot. If you want to get some Silgenot from our sponsor, Keaton Bach, just text BIND to 55444, text BIND to 55444. So this patient was the newest patient to me. So we talked about what happens if you need a sinus lift. So I say, no, we do. We just jam up the sinus as high as it goes. No, we don't talk like that. We say, hey, you know, we ever been at a party and there's like the tent falls down and we push it back up? That's a sinus lift. We gently push it back up. So that was the next visit. Then I had a hygiene check. You think, oh, hygiene checks, they're not real visits. Well, when you've been a dentist for 18 years, you find out hygiene check, every visit is a real visit. Every visit where you have to walk into a room and see a person who you don't know and talk to them about their mouth, that's a real visit. It doesn't matter if you're doing a occlusal composite, a crown, a molar, the challenging nature of the clinical procedure is not as big an effect on your stress as processing people. So I have to process all these people in a short time frame here as a dentist. So we did a hygiene check, and this patient has a cavity underneath number 15 and crown. It's like in his 50s. So we talked about saving it like Private Molar Ryan or ripping it out of his head. But we didn't use those words because those are insane, unlikable words. We use words like, we could maintain this tooth, but doesn't have the greatest chance of working out, but we can maintain it. Or we could remove it and place an implant, a bridge, a partial, more on that later. And then my favorite visit of my 9 o'clock hour, the fourth visit, was inserting complete upper and lower dentures. Why was that fun? Not because they work awesome, because they don't, but it helps the patient look awesome. It's an instant makeover, and I said that, but here's my talking tip. On the complete upper and lower denture, you can use it. It's free. Change your words. It's free. You don't have to invest in words. You just say different words. You don't say virgin. You say tooth without a filling. Don't say virgin. Very weird and unlikable. Say tooth without a filling. So I just saw this patient, and she got her complete upper and lower dentures, and she looks great. Celebrate that. I said, hey, it's like an instant makeover. Show your friends, because she didn't have any teeth. Now, I did remind her, here's the key tip. These are smiling dentures. Dentures without implants are for smiling, not chewing. Dentures without implants are for smiling, not chewing. Great talking tips. That was my first hour, four people, team, really helped me get through the day, but a lot of things I managed with the team. So I think we need to share more about our real practice life. So I feel like if you're a dentist out there, dentisting, trying your best, doing full contact arts and crafts on people who don't want to be here, share in the comments. What do you have going on today? What are some talking tips? How do you get through your day without crying inside too often? Impossible not to cry inside at all. I've cried inside at least 3 or 4 times today. It's only 10, like 10, 15 a.m. I'm just hoping I don't get to 50. My average, like when I started as a dentist, it was like 70. Now it's down to like 20. That's pretty good. What do you do to prevent yourself from crying inside each day? What are some systems you use? Everything that matters needs a system, and everything matters. If you want any help from us, you can reach out to me at my dental office, PenningtonDentalCenter.com. That's where I work here. And you also can reach out to us at DentalNachos.com. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll update you guys in a little bit with the next hour.